Hello everybody, this is John again with my second EV range test. But a couple days ago I used my kilowatt to verify the amount of energy going into the Niro to charge its battery. Like that time, right now I'm at 30 miles with 28% left of the battery. Last time I had 25% per that meter, and right now I have 25.5% left on the battery according to the ODBC information. And what happened last time, or when I charged the battery this last time, is it needed about 6.5 kilowatts of power to charge the battery. The kilowatt meter told me it actually took about 8.66 kilowatts, which means the inefficiency in at least charging at 120 volts is about 33%. If you plan on charging 33% more than the battery says it's going to need, and that means that if you think that it's going to take at most 8.9 kilowatt hours to charge the battery fully, it's really going to take probably about 12 to 13 kilowatt hours. When it comes to the costs of doing the charge, the rate of power for me where I live is about 12 cents per kilowatt hour, but that's just for the energy. I have to add on top of that additional charges the power company decides to apply, such as fuel costs, which is also done per kilowatt hour, and delivery cost of electricity, which is also per kilowatt hour. And that adds about 4.4 cents to the cost of electricity. So that brings the total cost up to 16.75 cents per kilowatt hour. And in charging last time, if I use the efficiency, the miles per gallon of this car when it's in normal hybrid mode, about 47 miles per gallon, the cost of charging the battery is equivalent to paying about $2.17 per gallon in gas. And my local gas is right now $2.54. So it's not as cheap as if you just look at the raw dollars per kilowatt hour, but it's still cheaper than actually having to fill the car with gasoline.